be too long again, but this afternoon, my topic. Touch by God. Touch by God. You see it well? When you be touched by the Master, you are a new creature. I said, when you be touched by our Redeemer, our Shepherd, the one who gave us life, the one who have us breathing, when you be touched by Him, you are a new creature, you are a new creation. All things has been passed away and everything become new. And my servant, my scripture, as a matter of fact, to go with that topic is John 16 and 7. St. John, thank you, Lord. St. John 16 and 7.
Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you.
Amen. And my brothers and sisters in the Lord, you hear what the Lord is saying to His Son, Yahshua. He said, I have to go. Because if I don't go, the Comforter will not come. Hello, the Comforter. The Comforter is our Master, Lord Elijah. Yeah. Yeah. And without the Comforter in these days, in these times, Israel, we are doomed. Yeah. I said, without the Comforter in these days and in this time, Israel, we are doomed. So we must be wrapped up. Notice I say, be wrapped up. And also be tangling up in the Lord Elijah. So as well, and my friend out there, who are not a part of this family as yet, in order for us to be touched by God, to get to know God, we must surrender all.
Amen.
We must surrender. We must open up to Him. It's very important. And also another thing, we must not be ashamed. You hear what Paul said? The same man who was named was Saul. And they persecute the people of God who talking about God and so forth and preaching the name of the Lord. He said, anytime I see you, I'm preaching the name of the Yahshua, I want to put some of you in the lockup. But hear what? As the Bible say, when Paul was on the road and the masters, you make a joke with the Lord Elijah, a bright light. Notice I say a bright light as well. And I know all the kind of light. A pure light. All that sun, cup, and blindness eyes. And all of a sudden hear the voice. So, wipe down persecuting me. Yeah. And he said, who thou, Lord? Conscience bite him. He now realize he is kicking against the people of God. He's kicking against God.
Yeah.
And this same man who never saw, God changed his life.
Yeah.
You see what I'm talking about? The touch of God.
Yes.
God changed his life from an old man to a new man.
Yeah.
And when God is ready for changes, like God did speak to one individual. And the individual said this, then the man there, he's a murderer. God said, I know. But he has chosen by me. You know when you're chosen by God, it ain't got no man can stop. This God's spell.
Amen.
When you're chosen by God, you're chosen by God. And this man, this same man, boldly say, I am not ashamed of the gospel, but its power of the salvation.
Yeah.
Israel, let us continue to be ashamed of this truth. Let us not continue to be ashamed of the proclaiming the name of the Lord Elijah.
Amen.
Just like Yahshua when he was here as the forerunner on behalf of the Lord Elijah. Let us do what the Lord Elijah has laid upon our hand. Let us in our school, you see now in these days, I don't have to talk anything about God now in these times. But you see, back in my days when I used to go to school, every man jack had a prayer. Boys and gotta line up with boys, girls gotta line up with girls and begin to pray. But you see, a man change the system. But how can I live without God? And it's the same God that I'm breathing. It is saying God got my heart beating. I can't an individual. It said that you're not take no screwdrivers to see what's wrong with your heart. And indeed as well, we got take no screwdriver to see what's wrong with the heart. I take no pliers to see. And whatever, for see what's wrong with my mind. Everything is intact. And not nothing about us. It's all about God. So as well, let me continue to strive to stay in truth with the Lord Elijah. And my next scripture, Colossians 3:3.
For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God.
You see what I'm talking about? There's where we have thought about the Lord Elijah. You're dead. In other words, the old man who the whole you dead. You're dead to Easter.
Yeah.
You're dead to Christmas.
Amen.
You're dead to Pagwa.
Yeah.
You're dead to Diwali.
Amen.
Even dead to Boxing Day. Old Year's, New Year's.
Yeah.
Well, we got everything different when it comes in our houses, man. But But these things were not of God. You're dead. You see, Israel, I heard sometime that the master they preach on this when I listen the same thing. And indeed we are dead to these things. And when we dead to it, we can't go back to it. Come on, Israel. When we dead to Israel, dead warrior, but we cannot go back to it. We gotta stay new. We gotta stay pure. And this morning the topic was about pure. You gotta stay pure. When you're an Israelite, you gotta continue, let the people in the world see you as an Israelite. You gotta let your workmate see you as an Israelite. Your boss, your manager, you as an Israelite. We can't never tell something is well. It's not your mask or your breathing. Yeah. It's not your mask or your heart beating. It's God. It's not your mask getting the strength to go to work. Where you gotta go and walk. It's all about God. So that's why we must all time remember the Lord Elijah. In season and out of season, because he gave us power to get wet. And without the Lord Elijah give us power to get wet, we will not go and work. As a matter of fact, we wouldn't get the energy to go and work. Says, well, as I about to conclude, to let my dear friend come upon the pulpit, I say, Israel, let us continue, stay pure. And when the Lord Elijah come, made it him come and see us pure. Just like the five wise virgins. Let us be separate. Let us be separate. Friends who have time with God, let me cut myself them from those friends. And stay with friends. People who will have time for God. People who need God. And people who desire to do what God will desire of them.
Go down, Moses.